We're looking at the Edexcel FP2 question on second order differential equations from June 2011, question 8. In this question, we're given a second order non-homogeneous differential equation to solve. We need to find the general solution for 8 marks and then the further particular solution based on the given conditions for 5 marks. We then need to find the coordinates of the first turning point on the solution curve when t is bigger than 30. The first thing we need to do is to consider the homogeneous case. And that is where the differential equation equals 0. So we need to find a solution to the homogeneous case. And we're going to try a solution of the form a e to the mt, where a is a non-zero constant. So this will give me dx by dt using the chain rule is am e to the mt, and again d2x by dt squared is am squared e to the mt. So substituting all this into the homogeneous case, notice the 6 dx by dt's. And 9 x terms. I can take out a con factor of a e to the mt. I know the constant a is defined as being non-zero. The exponential e to the mt can't be zero. So we have what's called the auxiliary equation, which is x m squared plus 6m plus 9, which is the 0. This is a perfect square and gives me the repeated solution, m is minus 3. Because it's repeated, my CF, my complementary function, which is an important part of the process, will be x equals, and because of the repeated solution for m, I need an a plus bt term in my complementary function. So that's my complementary function, which will form part of my general solution. To find the general solution, we now need to consider the non-homogeneous case, which is the given non-homogeneous equation. So we need to find a function of x which will solve this case. And we're going to try a particular integral of the form x equals, because the non-homogeneous case equals cos 3t, we need p cos 3t, and we need the general case which could involve q sine 3t as well. So we need to carefully differentiate this to find dx by dt. Watching out for the chain rule. Minus 3p sine 3t. And again a chain rule, 3q cos 3t. And I need to differentiate it again to get minus 9p cos 3t minus 9q sine 3t. Substituting all of this into non-homogeneous case, we get the following. Don't forget the 6 dx by dt's. And the 9 x's. And it all has to equal, don't forget on the right hand side, cos 3t. So I've rewritten this equation, having removed all of the brackets just to make it easier to identify the terms. We now still need to find the constants P and Q. So I can go through looking at the coefficients of cos 3t and sine 3t. So that's the notation for picking out the coefficients of cos 3t. So I'm looking at that term, that one, and of course, don't forget the one on the right-hand side. So I get minus 9p plus 18q plus 9p, and there's one on the right-hand side. So that gives me, the p terms cancel out, that gives me q is 1 over 18 straight away. I can do a similar method and pick out the sine 3t coefficients as well. So that would be that one, and of course there aren't any on the right hand side. So this time I get minus 9q minus 18p plus 9q, and there aren't any sine 3t's on the right hand side. So solving that for p, p must be 0. So that gives me what's called the particular integral. The particular integral is the solution for x for the non-homogeneous case. And in this case, it's x is an 18th of sine 3t. Okay, so now we can find the general solution. The general solution is the complementary function that we've previously found plus this particular integral. So the general solution is x equals a plus bt e to the minus 3t plus the particular integral, which is an 18th sine 3t. And that is the general solution of the differential equation. The marking for this part of the question gives a method mark for using the auxiliary equation, an accuracy mark for the correct form of the complementary function, a B1 mark for attempting to use the correct particular integral, an M1 mark for finding the derivatives of x, an M1 mark for substituting them into the non-homogeneous equation. There's a method mark for comparing the coefficients of cos 3t and sine 3t, and an accuracy mark for finding q and p, and then an accuracy mark for the final general solution, and that's following through from previous accuracy answers. We're now going to find the particular solution for 5 marks based on the given conditions. So we need to find the constants for A and B. We can quickly start off by subbing t is naught, x is 1/2, into our general solution. So t is 0, so we've got a plus nothing times e to the nothing plus an 18th of sine nothing. Sine nothing is nothing, e to the nothing is 1, so we get a must be 1/2. In order to use dx by dt, we're going to have to differentiate our function of x. So to find dx by dt, we very carefully need to do a product rule here. We could do that product rule using u's and v. So if you were going to do a traditional product rule, you would let u equal a plus bt, and v is e to the minus 3t, and find du by dt and dv by dt. So I'm going to do those by inspection as I'm going along. So I'm going to differentiate the bracket times leave the exponential plus leave the bracket times differentiate the exponential is e to the minus 3t, And then because of the chain rule, we'll get a minus 3 term in front of the bracket. Don't forget we need to differentiate an 18th sine 3t. So that's going to be 3 18ths, again because of the chain rule, cos 3t. Now we can sub in, and t is naught, the gradient is naught as well. So we get 0 equals b times e to the nothing, which is 1, minus 3 times a plus nothing times e to the nothing, which is 1, plus 3 18ths of the cos of nothing. And of course the cos of nothing is 1, so at the end we get 3 18ths times 1. And that will give me the value of B is 4 thirds. So I now have what's called the particular solution, the PS. We found A and B, so the particular solution is X equals 1/2 plus 4 thirds of t times e to the minus 3t plus an 18th sine 3t. So we found all the constants, so that is a unique particular solution. The mark scheme for this part of the question gives a B1 mark for simply seeing that A is 1/2, a method mark for the correct use of the product rule and differentiating x, a method mark for substituting in the conditions, an accuracy mark for finding the last constant b, and an accuracy mark for the final particular solution. The last part of this question, we need to find the turning point, the first turning point after t reaches 30. So we need to consider dx by dt as well. So if I differentiate this, I differentiate the bracket, times leave the exponential, plus leave the bracket, times differentiate the exponential again, it will give me a minus 3 when I use the chain rule. And then differentiate an 18th of sine 3t will give me a 6 of cos 3t. So the first consideration is we need the first turning point after t has reached 30. So we need t to be bigger than 30. There's a couple of important implications here. If t is bigger than 30, then e to the minus 3t is going to be very, very small indeed. And we know we're looking for a stationary point, a turning point, so we need dx by dt to be 0. So we'll have 0 will be approximately cos 3t. And we need to find 3t, the first solution for 3t, which is bigger than 30. And that will happen when 3t is pi by 2 plus a multiple of pi. And the first time that will happen is when t has reached 59 pi by 6. Which is approximately 30.6. So this will be the first turning point beyond 30. So t is approximately 30.6. If you go back and look at the x equation, don't forget that the exponential part is very small. So the e to the minus 3t is very, very small indeed. Therefore x is going to be approximately an 18th of sine 3t, and sine 3t will be minus 1 at this value of t. So x will be minus 1 18. So the coordinates of A will be T is approximately 30.6 and X is minus 1/18. The mark scheme for this question offers a B1 for seeing T is approximately 30.6 and a B1 follow through for seeing X is approximately minus 1/18. You can get more information from the Further Mathematics Support Programme website at www.furthermathematics.org.uk.